Hi, welcome you all. First of all, I like to thank to Arasu College of Engineering Management and my organization for giving this opportunity to deliver this natural language processing to all. Shall we start the session?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. One second. Okay. I hope you're able to see my screen.
Yes, sir. It's
visible. Yeah. Actually, my audio is echo, I guess.
No, sir. It's clear only. No problem.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir. It's echoing.
Okay. Someone needs to switch off the audio. Ma'am, can you mute your mic?
Yes, sir.
Is it audible now? Okay. Thank you to the college management. So, whenever that Kannan sir addressing that, this is a trending technology, and sure it will be useful for all of us. Before going to that session, I have to give a self-declaration of my photo mentioned in the brochure, right? I certified that the photo mentioned in the brochure is mine. I'm about to provide it true and complete it to the best of my knowledge. So that photo is before COVID. So BC, this is AC, after COVID. Okay, we'll go to the session. In this natural language processing, if you go to that NLP, first we have to know about the languages. So approximately more than 7,000 languages are spoken by around 7 billion people around the world, that human languages. In this human languages, only in 20% of the language in a structured format, like we are chatting, we are discussing to others in an email or any content. So it is in only 20% in a structured format. Okay. So what is language? See, while we are trying to communicate with others, so we can call it as a structured system. So it is coming from whenever we evolved. So by using sounds or gestures, verbal or non-verbal communication, the study of language we call it as linguistics. So it is very wonder thing. So whenever you are trying to learn a new language, or if you doesn't understand other languages, obviously it will be like a alien thing for you. In childhood itself, if you are in the same background, if you are trying to learn, for example, it's a Tamil or English. So we are learning that language step by step. It's not like a one day process. It will take so much of time. In childhood itself, we have started speaking Amma, Dad. So in Tamil, Appa, Amma, like that, we'll start speaking like that. So same like that. Okay. In computing evolution. I hope we all of them knows in 1980s, while a personal computer came, we are interacted with that personal computer by using floppy disk or any punch cards like that. Then 1990s, human interface devices came. So like a mouse, a touchpad, or a track pen, light pen like that. Then in 1995, all of them, we have smartphones, right? So, cell phones. In cell phones, we can easily communicate to others. We can send text messages to everyone. And after that 2000, the smartphones come into the market. So we can easily install the applications. We can communicate all over the world by using that smartphone, anything. So anything, what are the thing? Computing is possible in a PC or laptop. We can do it in a mobile. So after 2010, what is that? Now we are going to see about what is that computing evolution. Okay, so before that, okay, our topic is NLP, natural language processing, right? So that natural language processing it's a combination of our human language with artificial intelligence model, and it is in a computer science part, right? So we have some machine learning process, and by using that we are training our system. We are trying the language. For example, if you take any one of the stranger, and we will teach them a new language like that. So we have to give a linguistics to the system, everything, AI, all those things we are giving to that system. So that is we called as natural language processing. Okay. So components of NLP. There is a main two components in a natural language processing. One is natural language understanding, and another one is natural language generation. Okay. How this NL understanding comes? I'm already told you, right? If any baby or toddler, they have to first understand your language. See, if they are started speaking, or they will try to understand that language, or you are going to learn a new language, you are trying to learn that, right? Okay, I will just show you one clip. If you don't know understanding the language, how it will be? I will share my tab once again. Okay, so I will just show you one small humorous clip, okay, about language understanding. Okay, before do that, unknown language.
Nimda, dozras tell me, har tabush crack oik nim bumla, mohino zuku lohakwe.
So, hope you saw that audio, right? It's a clip from a Bagubali film. So why I showed that clip is same like that. If we doesn't give any natural language understanding process, that there is no natural language generation. Okay, in this clip, can anyone say or a subtitle what he is exactly he's saying? Surely not, right? So if we are trying to learn a new language, once again, let me back to my 1 minute. Thank you. Okay, if you are trying to learn a new language, or we are trying to the system doesn't know what it is. Okay, if you are coming to that computer science part, we are developing programmings for C or C sharp, everything, right? So what we'll do, we write some programming languages. So we are write some codes, correct? In that code, obviously it is in English, it has some structures, syntax, so everything, the programs will be in a syntax or structures like that. Once that natural language understanding how the come to the picture in the programming means, so instead of giving that machine codes, we are going to give our natural language. So for example, I want to write one application, I want to write a print hello world program means, I can, instead of writing print hello world, I can tell like that, hey Google, say hello world, like that I can say like that. The next one is natural language generation. Once it is understood, then it will be try to communicate it in a duplex communication. It will try to communicate with the humans and machine. Duplex communication will be there. Okay, so now I come to the NLP terminologies. Okay, in this natural language processing, I already told you, if it is a baby or toddler, the step by step process of that learning is necessity, right? Same like that in NLP, there is some terminologies is there. First one is tokenization. Second one is stemming, then lemmatization, PO stacks, named entity recognition, and chunking. Okay, we are going to see how this is going to implement. So first, tokenization. So tokenization is nothing. It's a first step of the NLP. For example, if you are going to learn a new language, first you will split it into the tokens. Let's say, have you ever seen the flashcards? By using the flashcards, baby or toddler will learn. So A for apple, B for ball, so C for cat, like that. Now it's changed. So A for again, A for it is apple, B for bingo, like that. It is changed, right? In that tokenization, there we have to split the entire strings, or else what are all the learning content? We have to tokenization, and by using some machine learning models and algorithm, we will push into the system. For make the machine learn for the entire sentences. Okay. Next one is stemming. So this is very interesting part. Whenever the word is there, we have to find the base form or root form. So here I have some list of words. Dreamed, dreaming, dreams, dreamed, right? So there is some list of words is there. In this word, what will be the root word? Obviously, the root word is dream. Whenever the system, you are going to tell something, or I'm dreaming, So it is a good dream. Sweet dreams. Good night, sweet dream. Like that. So that root word is dream only here. Next one is lamentation. So that lamentation and stemming, moreover, it is like same, but the difference is it will give the proper word for which word the which stanza will helpful for matching. For example, we have a gone, going, and went. Means went is a past thing, right? So the apt word is go. The system will understand about, okay, he was trying to convey that is that content is go, like that. PO stacks. If you are good in grammar, English, POS means what? Part of speech. I have small word here. The dog killed the bat. That is a sentence. In the sentence, we have a determinant here, common noun, and verb is there. That is past tense, and determinant, again determinant, and common noun. The system will create that part of speech tag. See, for example, there is a lot of same like if you seen Indran 2.0 or Indran movie, that Chitty Robo will learn while he inserted the hard disk. It's not like that. So the system need to be understand a lot of thing in this process, like tokenization, stemming, lemmatization. The next process is part of speech. Part of speech is very important thing. See, if the system trying to reply dog killed the bat, if change that past tense to the present or future tense, obviously it will be a misunderstanding with the humans and machines. That is why that PO stacks will be the main content. Next one is named entity recognition. Okay, I will ask one a small question. If anyone knows, just raise your hand. I will continue the conversation. Okay, the thing is, anyone used Google Assistant here? Okay. Okay, Gauri, you can unmute and you can say something. What about Google Assistant? Okay, they just raise their hands. Okay. Okay. That named entity recognition, if you are using Google Assistant or if you are using Google search engine, what is the latest movie released on Amazon Prime? If I search like that, but before going to that, there is a tough thing to me, because today in Amazon Prime, one of the that new movie was released in OTT, right? So I think that's why that participant count is less, I guess. Okay, while you are searching in Google, what is the new movie released, or can you show the theaters nearby? The content, what is the new movie, is the entity. Like that, the entire content will be separated into movie. Or if you want to convert the dollar into the amount, if you ask what is the current Indian rupees, what is the current Indian rupees rate of the dollar, like that, can you convert the dollar into the amount? That is, we call it as a monetary value. The next one is organization. If you want to search something, okay, whether Tariq is working in TIPS, like that, if you search in Google, so the TIPS is an organization. And what about that Aras Engineering College? If you write the query like in Google search engine, so that Aras Engineering College is an organization. Then again, location. Can you show me the nearby places? Okay, like that, if you ask to the Google, that is, we call it as a location one. Then quantities. See, first I will tell you about that NLP basics. Then we'll go to for the demo section. So it might be a little vague while I'm telling this, but try to understand this thing. Okay. Then quantities. Quantities, feet to meter or meter to centimeter, like that, for conversation. So person is, so if you are telling some person name, so Tariq or Kannan or Parvati, like that, if you telling that name, so we call it as that named entity recognition person. Okay, I took one small example. I will show this demo also after this explanation. Okay, so this is a glimpse of the Aras Engineering College newspaper headline. Okay, I just translated into the English. The content is Kumbhakonam Arasu College students new invention, Minister Prize. So in this, how here named entity recognition work, as well as part of speech and lemma. Okay, so while I'm put this string into that Google NLP, how it is given a written result. So it take that Kumbhakonam as a noun, it's a singular. So Kumbhakonam here, it is a location, and the punctuation mark, we are called as a PRT. So again, RSC Engineering College, that is a noun, and it's a phrase, Engineering is a singular noun, college is a singular noun. So again, it is a punctuation. Students means, you can see that student is a word, I'm already told you. Student is a root word from a students, correct? So it is telling that noun is a plural. So next one is, it's a new invention. We are telling new. New is a adjective, obviously. So minister prize, again, it is noun and noun. How the entire sentence was separated and it need to be understand. For example, if I want to say you something, hi, how are you? Like that means you have to understand what I am trying to say and you have to reply to me. So that is what our end-to-end conversation, right? Same like that, system need to understand. If I say something to the system, it should be understand. Next one is chunking. Okay, I have one humorous content for this chunking video also, content also, but in PPT, I am not able to show, or later I will show it to you, okay? In chunking, after we done all the process, what we done? We done tokenization, stemming, lemmatization, and we found the part of speech tags, and we named that entity. Finally, we have to group it, okay? So those individual piece, we have to group it and we have to make it in a bigger piece. That chunk, we have to make it as a grouping. So that is, for example, finally, we get a one full word. That is called chunking. Okay, this is the example. We got the pink panther. So V means preposition. It understood. So based upon a stemming, lemmatization, POS, cot means adjective. The pink panther, the NP means that is a noun phrase. The entire thing is taken as a noun phrase and DD is determinant. Pink, you know, that is adjective, correct? JJ. And panther is common noun. That is a one content name. So finally, we are chunking this content. Then only system will understand. For example, if I say to the Google, we caught the pink panther. The background process will do all those things and it will understand. If you are trying to search something, it will be understand like that only. Okay, what is the applications on the NLP? First one is sentiment analysis. Okay, I given this GIF from a Facebook emotions, right? So the sentiment analysis, system doesn't know. See, it's same like, again, I will say the Chitty film example, that hero will give the sentiment to emotions to that mission. How the system will know? So for example, initially in Facebook, we have only like button. So like means, that content the user can like or not. Now we have the various of emotions, right? So machines will learn like that. If I give haha symbol means, obviously it will think it might be some comic or it will be some meme. Or if we are telling wow, so it might be some surprised or inspired content kind of thing. Sad means obviously the system will try to understand what is the content like that. Where this sentiment analysis will work? For example, if we are giving some review to the Amazon, okay, there is a tons of reviews will be there. So machine learning, how it will be workers, it will take the content, whether it will be in a good mood or positive mood. Even if you are giving a 3 rating review, it will taken in a good or positive, or it will be a worst. It will be classified like that. Second one is chatbot. Okay. So previously in all industries, we have a telecaller or some people need to address your queries and they have to reply back to you, correct? So now chatbot comes. There is no need of a physical person should be needed for in a telecaller or KPO processing. So chatbot will take care all those things. Then speech recognition. Speech recognition is nothing. It's like a, more or less it's a single way communication. It's not like a fully duplex. For example, in our system in Cortana, we say, okay, open, hi Cortana, open this file, or Siri, hi Siri, send text message, like that. Initial thing, actually Siri is not only the speech recognition, it is also a duplex, I'm giving the example only. Those things will come into the picture of the application of NLP. Final thing is machine translation. Here, I'm giving the application of NLP in a major part only, some of the applications also is there. So machine translation is, if you are trying to translate some content, Tamil to English, English to Tamil, or English to any languages, Hindi, system will understand your content and it will translate into that part. That is one thing. Okay. As of now, any doubts from your side? Anyone have a doubt? You can raise your hand and you can ask a question. Anyone?
No, sir, it's clear only. You can continue.
Okay. So I hope my audio and video both is clear. Okay. So now I will show you one small video clip. In this, actually, in Google Meet, I'm shared my presentation in separate. I have to stop the sharing and again I have to share it. So please bear with me. I will show you one small video clip. Okay. Before do that, I will ask you one question. If anyone knows, they can drop it in a chat box. Okay. I'm just watching that chat box also. Okay. I'll ask one question. Okay. The people, all of them know about IoT, right? IoT means what? It is one part of NLP. System need to be understand what you are trying to say, and it will send the proper commands to the hardware things or sensors. Okay. In fiction, I'm again asking that question. In fiction, who is the forerunner of this NLP IoT? Any idea? In fiction. In fiction means you able to understood, right? Fiction. Any idea? You can drop it in chat box. I'm eagerly waiting. Just for 10 seconds. No idea. Okay. Let me share my screen. Sure. Hope it will be interest and the thing in fiction. So it is a online session. So no one will be given a laugh out of loud. Unless until you are giving a unmute to your mic. Okay, shall we see? Okay, we'll see.
Anda ka kasam, abu ka hukum, kiran did si sev.
So now you can say, right? Are you able to hear my audio? So that film is a fiction one for the IoT, right? For NLP, it's a they are the forerunners for this concepts. Okay. So next one is I will just show you that interesting content. One minute. Okay. Now we are seeing about telling about that NLP, IoT, and all. Now, real how the real IoT works, we'll see. Okay. It's like it is a Google Assistant, and it's a Google Home. It's just a 2 minute video. I will just quickly play this.
Okay, Google, play the morning playlist.
Okay, playing morning playlist.
Okay, Google, play music in all rooms.
Okay, Google, I'm listening.
Your flight to Portland is delayed by 30 minutes.
Change my dinner reservation tonight from 7:30 to 8.
Your reservation at Andina is now confirmed for 8 p.m.
Hey, Google, text Louise. Flight is delayed. Dinner moved to 8.
Okay, message sent.
Morning.
Morning. Hey, Google, turn the lights on in Kevin's room.
I thought you finished that already.
I forgot. Okay, Google, what's apples in Spanish?
Manzanas.
Hey, Google, has my package shipped?
Yes, it's already shipped. It'll arrive tomorrow.
Ooh, is that for me?
Maybe.
Interesting.
Okay, Google, how many stars are in our galaxy?
Well, there are about 100 to 400 billion stars, according to space.com.
Which star is the closest?
According to NASA, the nearest star system is Alpha Centauri.
Can you show me what it looks like on the TV?
Okay, Google, how's the traffic from Pebble Rock School to the airport?
Your normal route has heavy traffic. There's a faster one that'll take about 35 minutes. I've sent it to your phone.
Okay. Go!
Dad!
Hey, Google,
What's on the calendar today?
The first event is Space Day at Kevin's school. It starts at 8 a.m.
Space Day. Are you ready, buddy?
Ready.
Let's go. Come on.
Okay, Google. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I hope all of them see that video in a less streaming, right? Is that audio is clear in that content? Hope it is clear. Okay. So that is the Google Assistant, that device called Google Home. Have you heard about that Alexa? Alexa is an Amazon product. So Amazon Echo, like that. Okay. So now I will just show again. I will show my PPT. Okay. The same video, what are the things you have seen? Can we create those applications, whether it is open for the developers? Means, yes. In Amazon Alexa, you can write the skills. Like the same in Google Assistant also, you can use it. So how many of them used Google Assistant in your phone? Anyone raise your hands or put it in a chat box. In that video, you are seeing, okay, that's good. In that video, Pavi told she used, that's good actually. In that video, you have seen Google Home, that device called Google Home. It is connected with, it's moreover like working as IoT. It is connected with our home sensors, lights, everything. Okay, we can also do the development for this Google Assistant. Now in this NLP session, I'm fully showing about that Google Assistant content only. Okay. So we need, before going to that demo, we need to know little understanding, okay, about that Google Assistant actions on, we call it as actions on Google, okay, that the development for that process, we call it as actions on Google. How that assistant NLU is working means, in Google you can ask, what's the forecast like? What's the current, what is the weather like today? What is the temperature like in San Francisco tomorrow? Or else whether it is raining in Kumbakonam tomorrow, like that you can ask. And or else you can ask, Arasu Engineering College is open tomorrow, like that. You can ask the multiple queries to the assistant NLU and it will match the intent and it will give the result. So I can give some real-time example. You just go to some Kirana shop, that is some grocery shop. Not like a supermarket, direct grocery shop. It's a normal shops. If you go to the go there, the shopkeeper will ask, "Hi sir, what do you want?" Then you can reply, "I need a hammam soap." Okay, it will kill coronavirus, right? 99.9 germs. So I will ask like, "I need a hammam soap." So then the person go to that particular rack and he take that soap and he will give to us. Let assume the same thing. If you are asked to the Google or assistant NLU, what's the weather like today? It will take the content. Okay, weather means I have to take the weather content. Today means I have to take the date and time. It will match that intent and it will give to the result accordingly. Okay, we'll see little more detail about that actions on Google. In demo section, I will just show you a lot of things. Okay. First, you have to understand this key terms. Then only you can go into that. The terms is main invocation, scene, user intent, training phrases, transition, prompt, slot fillings, slot types, conditions. Main invocation. What is main invocation? Okay. Main invocation is nothing. If someone calling you by your name, for example, my name is Tariq, right? Hi Tariq. Hey Tariq. Like that, someone calling me. That is called main invocation. I will respond, right? If someone call my name means, obviously I will respond. So that is called as main invocation. In your Android application, if you want any applications, what you will do? Obviously, you just open your unlock your phone and you can click that particular application. That is, we call it as main invocation. Okay, the next one is anyone have a doubt? Someone raise their hand. Can I pause or can I continue? Okay, so that is, we call it as main invocation. Next one is scene. You understood the main invocation, right? In an application, if you are clicking some particular application, if that application is pop up, that we call it as a main invocation. In the same application, you can have number of screens, login screen, initial screen, or admin screen, like that. Lot of screens you have. Let's take the example of the WhatsApp. If you are open that application, in a friend screen, you have a chat, list of chats. That is one scene. If you are clicking that particular person or particular contact, it will go to the conversation of the other screen with you and that particular person. That is, we call it a scene here. There it is screen. In actions on Google, it is a scene. User intent. Here it is an interesting thing came. User intent, I am already told you, if you go to some the real-time example I am given, we go to any grocery shops, okay, to that person, if you're asking some, can you show that latest some latest fashion items or accessories came, or if I want some mobile cover, or if I want some screen guard, can you show that the particular screen guard to me, like that? The grocery shops, it will not be. So it is in a mobile shop. I'm just giving that example. Okay, if you want something, if you are asking that person, that grocery, the person who is the helper, he is taking that particular thing to you, right? Same like that in actions on Google or Google Assistant. If you say something, I need to know about the current scenarios. If you told like that the sentence, it will take that proper intent to you and it will give it. Okay, next one is training phrases. Obviously, I already told you, we have in NLP, we have a tokenization content and lemmatization and stemming. These three will come in a training phrases. Transition. In normal Android application itself, what you will do if you are selecting something or chat, if you want to add some images or video, if you are inserting into that, if you are clicking that clip icon, that upload screen will be open. That is, we call it as transition here. Next one is prompt. Prompt is simple. If you are, for example, here our student Gauri, a student, right? His Gauri Shankar. I can take his example. If I ask him, hi Gauri, like that, if he replies, hi Tariq, how are you, like that, if he replied, that is, we call it as prompt. Okay, the prompt will be anything. If he doesn't want to speak, he can show some cards, or he can give something like that. That is, we call it as prompt here. What is the response coming from the actions on Google? Next one is slot filling and slot. So slot filling is a very interesting thing. It's like a variables in our programming language. Slot filling is, if I'm asked to Gauri, if I don't know his name, what is your name? Okay, here the slot filling is a name is a slot filling. Okay, if he told my name is Gauri, like that, that Gauri name will be assigned to that name whenever I can remember. Whenever I try to say something to Gauri, mean hi Gauri, so Gauri, how do you do, like that. So that name is, we can tell it as a slots. Next one is types. So types here, we can say it as a options. In our website or web application, we have a list of menus, correct? In list of menus, we will select all the options. Same like that, in types we have conditions. Obviously, in programming languages, we have a conditions. If this condition is done, what will be the execution? Else, it go to the else part. Are you able to see my PPT? Okay, I come to that main invocation part. I already told you, it's an entry point for the user to start a conversation with your action. Okay, Same like you used Google Assistant, right? For example, in this demo, I'm going to show you how can you develop one small application in Actions on Google, develop, test, and deploy. Okay, I told you if you are already used Google Assistant, you can try this phase. I'm already deployed on content. Hey Google, talk to famous person. If I told this, it will invoke to that particular app. My app name called as famous person. So if you told, hey Google, talk to, that is the invocation phrase. That invocation name is famous person. If you told like that, NLP will understand, hey Google is a separate content and talk to is a separate line. So it will understand, okay, I have to open an application. I will do that. Okay, it will be implemented in Actions on Google itself. While I'm showing the demo, you can easily understand. Okay, so little, it's like a chart. Can anyone say which UML diagram it represents? Second year or third year students? It's represent which UML diagram? You can put it in a chat box. Okay, we'll go to that. In this chart, I'm going to say it is a flow chart. You have to tell me which UML diagram it is represent, if you know about this. Okay.
Maybe sequence, sir.
Sequence. Any other?
Or collaboration.
Okay, we can take it as sequence, collaboration. Any other? Okay, we'll go to this. Okay, we have a actions members here, user, assistant, and conversational action. Okay, whenever user trying to, okay Google, talk to, or hey Google, talk to that particular content, it will match the intent. I'm already told you, if you are telling something, it will match your intent and invoke that corresponding action, what it has to do, and will return that particular value or deliver that particular prompt to the user. So this is how main invocation is worked. Next. Intents. Told you, intent, it's represent a task assistant need your action to carry out, such as some user input that need processing or a system event that you need to handle. If you are going to discuss to some person, obviously you have to give your inputs. Then only they can understand what you are trying to communicate. Like the same, that intents help your invocation and conversational model. There is two types, is there. One is user intent and system intent. User intent is the intent you are going to develop. System intent is nothing. System intent is, it's a default intent. I told you, whether it's a system intent, date time is a system intent. For example, some conversational unit is a system intent. Those things already pre-built and pre-trained by Google, and it's NLP process. How this intent works? Okay. I will quickly wrap up. So don't get so. This flowchart will be whenever I showing the demo, you can relate to this. Okay. First one is, I told you, invocation model. Whenever you are trying to invoke, I told that key terms, scenes, correct? If you are invoke something, whenever if you say, hey Google, talk to like that, that invocation will match the intent and bring back to the particular scene. That scene have some input or custom intent handler, okay? So in that custom intent handler is nothing. So what it has to be do, that scene, while entering into the scene, how it will be respond to you. Same like in your application, if you are landed into any page, you can see, you can in WhatsApp, you can type something, that is called it as we chat. Condition is the person should be in your contact list. That slot filling, I already told you, slot filling like a variable thing. Once you done, it remembers. Prompt is how it going to respond to you. Okay, the content or message. For example, if message is delivered, you have a double tick. In Actions on Google, the prompt will like a visual response. or text speech response or content. Okay, and it need an input also. Obviously, if you have any inputs in a scene, then only it will work. Conversation. Okay, if I'm normally give a conversation to any person, or else in your classroom, it's not like a Google classroom. I'm telling a live classroom. If any staff taken any classes, if you don't have any idea about that, if you don't understand that concept, you can ask the question to the particular staff. The particular staff will get your query and they will match with the content what they delivered to you and what are the queries you are asked. Based upon that, they will give the output right to you. They will respond to you in a normal conversation. Same like that, this conversation in actions on Google also working. In user, if user query they given, it will do the intent matching and slot filling and give the same logic and deliver prompt. You can relate this content to the Google Assistant. The people's in, I hope in this session, most of the more than 80% of people's, they already used Google Assistant, I guess. You can relate this content to the Google Assistant. So it's really wonder, right? The Google Assistant already it is there. You are going to develop an application. It's like your personal chatbot or something, or that personal chatbot, the development you are going to do from your side. Next one is conversational actions. In conversational actions, there is a lot of things is there. First, I'm already told you that invocation model is there, intent is there. In intent, global intent, non-global intent, same like in our OOPs, we have a public and private. Those access variables is there, right? Access specifiers, same like that. In conversational model, we have a scenes, prompts, and types. What is the scene? I already told you. Prompt is it will give the response to you. Types is the options available in your system. Same in types, let you configure the assistant NLU engine to extract structured data from user input. So structured data means here, for example, in that options, which department you are going to choose? If system asks which department do you want to choose, they given a three options: CSE, mechanical, or EC. If it is say like that, you are going to choose something that here the types picture will come. Next one is scenes. Scenes we already I already told what is the scene. Here little elaboration of the content. In that scene, it's a combination of intents, scenes are major building block of that conversational model. Scene is a very important thing. In scenes represent individual state of your conversation. And their main purpose is organize your conversation into the logical chunks. I hope you remember the chunk keyword, right? The chunk word I told in a NLP main terminologies. Logical chunks, execute task, and return prompt to the users. So how it works? It's a looped execution. If you are opening some synthetic voice call, if you are going to the Airtel customer care, if you are called for Tamil, you can press 1. For Hindi, you can press 2. For English, you can press 3. Like that, it will say, it will get the input from you. Okay, that is a good example while I'm telling that synthetic voice call. Once you are here, the key press is the main event. But in a Google actions on Google, it's a dialogue. It will separate the dialogue. For example, if you're pressing the 2, it will take the particular action. Same like that, in dialogue separation, it will take entire dialogues into the separate part. It will do the stemming and lemmatization. And it will do the intent match scoping. So in which intent it is matching, which intent I need to show. And next final one is slot filling. Slot filling is, I already told you, if you are in variable, if you stored some value means the particular value will be returned. And in scene conditions, so which scene has to be shown, which has to be hide. Okay. That how the scene life cycle will be. Whenever it has entered to the scene, it will check the condition whether it will transit to the other match with the other intent or transition, or it will get the input, it will match the slot, it will do the intent handling. If it is a constant intent matching, it will do the intent handler. No match means automatically no match handler will be executed and it will go for the transition. This webhook, I will tell you about this webhook. Now you can skip it. Build a conversation model. Before do that, I will show one video to you all. Okay, 1 minute. I'm going to share that content. Okay, 1 second. Before showing that video, one industry called Soul Missions, they develop AI personalities with our virtual brain. Okay, it understands our natural language and it will respond like that. Now I'm going to show you about the Soul Missions created one application called Baby X. How it works, we'll see.
Actually learn, interpret and interact with the world around them like a real human.
What's this? Spider. So I'm starting to get a spider forming in their mind here. She started to associate the word with the image. So baby. Spider. Spider.
Spider.
Good. Okay. What's this?
Spider.
No. This is a duck. Look at the duck.
Duck.
Yeah.
It is very interesting, right? So now we are in that era. Just assume in especially for the students, how we are now, okay, how much we have to travel, what are the things we have to learn. I will show one more video, so let me show this 1 second. Okay, I told you I will put it in a chat box also. It's a Soul Missions. You can go and search once the session end. So that project called Baby X. Now I'm going to show you about Neon. So Neon is a interesting part. It is developed by Pranav Mistry. So Pranav Mistry is a well-known person. He's from India, and previously he worked in a Samsung research team. Now he done a separate startup and he is a CEO of that Neon. What is Neon? How it will do? First, I will show the video and I will give some examples.
Look at these people. They look like ordinary humans, right? Well, what if I told you that they're computer-generated images, graphics, models that are animated by an algorithm? Welcome to the future. They weren't kidding when they said Neon is an artificial human. These Neon promo videos were hidden in the source code of the...
Hope you are seeing that Neon, right? While I'm showing that video, sure, no one will really trust this content. Go to the Neon website and you can get to know. That content, the person what I showed in that video, those are AI models. It's generated computer generated images, same like the chitty robot in a real time. Like in a virtual environment, that system will interact like a real human to you peoples for a healthcare or news applications. For a lot of industries, they are using this NLP Neon. Okay. I will again come to my slide. Okay, so this conversational building, the conversational model will be like that. So invocational model, and it will go to the project info. Then it will take the display name, settings, resource, everything. Okay. It's a demo time. Fasten your seatbelt. Okay, we'll go for the demo. I will just stop this sharing and I'll share my screen. Okay, so if you are not able to hear my audio or something, you can unmute and you can say, okay. We'll go to the Google Assistant actions on Google. So this is the console. We are going to develop our application. This is the console. Okay, I'm obviously this is the action builder. We are using action builder and action in SDK. What are the things we are seeing in a presentation? Now we are going, I am going to show here. I'm going to give a new project. Okay, I'm going to give the project name. Project name is bot X. So I have to give this. Is my screen is visible? Any lag?
Yes, sir. Now it's clear, sir.
It's clear, right? Okay. In this first screen, it will ask, what is the action do you want to build? So we have a different thing: smart home, food ordering, game, storytelling, education. These, all those things are the templates. I'm going with the blank template. So we are going to develop our own custom. Okay. I'm clicking this custom tool and clicking next. Okay. Same. So what do you want to build? Like that it will ask. So there is a lot of template is there. It's an existing template. Fact about Google, Hello World, Firestore, Jungle Escape, or conversion components. We are going to build our application in a scratch. So I'm clicking the blank project. Clicking start building. It will take a few seconds. It will redirect to our next page. Okay. This is our action builder window. You can see all menus: overview, develop, test, deploy, analytics. While I'm showing in a PPT, it might be look like some alien content. Now you can refer it here: invocation, scenes, intents, types, interactive canvas, webhook. I will tell you the same. So theme customization, account linking, backend process. I told you main invocation. So if most of them are Tamil here, பேர் வைக்கணும். நம்ம பண்ண அப்ளிகேஷனுக்கு பேர் வைக்கணும். அதான மெயின் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். So we have to give the name for our application. பேர் வைக்கலனா we can never call it as. We have to give the name for that particular application. That is, we call it as here a main invocation. Okay. In main invocation, talk to my bot X. Okay. Once we done, and it will ask which one is needed. Google Assistant voice: female 1, female 2, female 3, male 1, male 2, male 3. And just selected female 2 now. So this is built-in intent. As of now, it is not needed. I'm clicking save. Once we given a name of our application, so then how our application will be called? If you told talk to bot X, okay, bot X, my talk to my bot X, our application will be called. So main invocation was done. Okay, this is it's very good thing, right? They are given when user says talk to my bot X, and fruitful content to the students. Okay, who don't have so much idea in programming languages, they can also develop this application. Okay, some students have more interested in development, some student have just very tough to understand the programming languages as per so it have some content, right? I have to put hash include in Python means I have to import something, I have to add it. Those people, I will tell you, this action builder is a zero level coding, but you need some logical content. Okay, in talk to my botx, when user says talk to my botx, it will invoke the action and will end the conversation. You can see the content here. Okay, I told you, right? Keyword prompts. Okay, send prompts. How it will be? YAML. Anyone know what is YAML? I'm just moved to the chat window. If anyone knows YAML, you can say. What is YAML? Any idea? Anyone knows? Okay. Other than that, what is YAML? No one. Just put it in a chat box. Anything. It's not like your Viva session here, students. Okay. I will tell you what is YAML. Okay. What is HTML? Oh, this is an easy question, right? You can say HTML is HTML is hypertext markup language, right? That YAML is nothing yet another markup language. That's all. We can call it as yet another markup language. So the history, those things and all will, if possible, we can see in other thing. Yeah, what CAC 2016, they told markup language. So YAML means yet another markup language. So, okay. This is one kind of a syntax. You no need to have more much into that. This will be pre-populated. So candidates means what are all the content here. The first simple is it's kind of a, if you're going to the JSON, you can see that it's a main thing. It's array candidates. Our next one is first simple and variants. In variants, we have a speech. Okay. It's interesting, right? In speech, it's the content of the output. So I'm going to give in this botx, I'm giving the content. Welcome to Arasu Engineering College. Okay. I will click save. Let's test this application. Very small application. It's like Hello World program. Okay. I hope you're able to see the screen. All of them. It will take a few seconds because it is in a fully in a cloud based. Okay. I'm going to say talk to my bot X.
All right, let's get the test version of my bot X. Welcome to Arasu Engineering College.
So now you are seeing you are in a first step. You can develop an application and it will prompt what is the content. So we are given welcome to Arasu Engineering College. I already told you we have to give a prompt. In this main invocation, where we need to transit. So transit to scenes, right? So we can add it here. Now as of now it is end conversation. Here we can add it start. Okay. If you are clicking start, in left side you can see the new scenes will be added. So scenes will be here, the list of scenes. So you can add it here also. From this transition also you can add it. I'm going to that scene. Okay, till now main invocation, hope all of them understood, I guess. The fruitful thing is I'm going to create one small bot. It have content of the RS Engineering College. That is what I'm going to do. Okay. As of now, any doubts? Okay. I'm going to that scenes. I'm clicking start. Okay. In that PPT, I have showed you. In scene, we have on enter what has to be happened, conditions, slot filling, user intent, error, and status handling. Okay. In this start, I'm going to add some content. If I click this on enter, again it will ask call your webhook or send prompts. I'm going to click send prompts. I'm going for ML only. Here I'm already written one statement. Are you ready for virtual tour? So if I give like this, are you ready for virtual tour? What might be the response from the user? If system asks like this to you, are you ready for virtual tour? What might be the response? Any guesses? See, simply if you are asking to the, if I'm go to the person for directly and I'm asking, are you ready for the virtual tour? Means what might be the response? Any guesses? Okay, very simple. If you click the suggestions, the suggestion will come. We can say yes and no. Okay, I have to click save again. Okay, now the interesting part going to come. It's simple like a Tariq, it's simple like a normal application. If you are giving yes no, it going to click yes, it is going to happen like that, someone can ask. But the interesting part is I'm going to create the intent and giving the training phrases to the NLP, natural language processing. I am going to write my own intent. I'm typing here yes, clicking yes. If I'm clicking yes again, I can add the training phrases. Here I edit global intent is there. I'm not going to edit any global intent. I'm going to add my phrases. I can say yes, yeah, I'm in, okay, we'll see. Okay. Okay, this is just still that six training phases I'm given. I'm interested. Once again, I'm interested. Go ahead. Okay, this is the training phrases we are given. We just click the save. I told you. Now I'm click the scene start. In this scene only, it asks a prompt. Are you ready for virtual tour? The suggestion will be yes or no. In this box, you can see on enter, condition, slot filling, user intent handling, right? In this user intent handling, you have to click plus and you have to select which intent need to call. Okay, once this is clicked yes, again you have to tell the transition, same like in our PowerPoint presentation, one slide to other, same like that. In this scene to which scene it has to be moved. Again I click and I will add the new scene called yes. That's all. In that yes scene, I'm going to the scene and again I click this. In on enter, same this scene, same like start. In on enter, I'm clicking send prompts here. Let's begin. Like that, I'm given the content. Okay, now we are going to test only this thing. We'll see how it works. As of now, any doubts? Any doubts till now? Okay. Okay. Again, talk to my bot X. Have some glitch. We'll see. I'll just click it again. Talk to my bot X. So real-time glitches also will come right in demo section. Okay, have some glitches, I guess. So instead of that, I'll just type it. Talk to my bot X.
Version of my bot X. Welcome to Arasu Engineering College. Are you ready for virtual tour?
I'm ready.
Sorry, I didn't catch that.
Okay.
Can you try again?
If you note this, I'm not given that intent as I'm ready. I'm given I'm in, we'll see like that. Okay, I will just give that training phrase word is we'll see. We'll see. Oh, it taken something else. Okay, I will type it. We'll retest from first. Okay, have some glitches here, so I'm giving talk to my bot X.
All right, getting the test version of my bot X. Welcome to Arasu Engineering College. Are you ready for virtual tour?
I'm telling yes. Yes.
Let's begin.
See, we are giving the prompt as let's begin, right? Now I'm going to develop little more detail. We already have yes intent. If no intent match means what it need to do. I have to create no scene. Before do that, I have to create a no intent. See, in this here I given go ahead. I'm interested. Okay, this prompt will be taken. So no means. Sorry, I have to give a thing. No, I have to click the intent no and click no and no. No, thanks. So this is the training phases I'm given. Okay, hope you remember. I have created the intent. I have a scene here. So I'm going to the start and I have to click user intent handling. When no is matched, I have to transit to no. Okay, I have to transit to the transition name called no. This simple yes no we are created. Now I'm going to little if user say yes, let's we are given what is the thing, let's begin, and we can ask which department information you need. So here we will give a suggestion. Before to that, I will come to the main part. Slot filling slot, I told you, right? Hope you all of them are remember slot fillings slot. I'm given an example of Gauri in that for slot filling. Give me a second, it's saving. Okay, it's done. So I'm going to click the types and clicking that type. I'm already wrote on blueprint for this. Types, call it as departments. In departments, I'm going to add the content, computer science engineering, mechanical engineering, like that. So first one is new entry. That entry is entity, we call it as entity, right? That is, I'm going to add computer science engineering. The key value is computer science engineering, and the content is CSE, CS, so computer science. Okay, so next one is mechanical engineering. I'll just take just two examples. Mechanical engineering. So mechanical engineering, we can say mech or mechanical, like that. I have to click yes. So here my types, call it as departments. I have to click save. Okay. Once that intent is matched, it will go to the scene as yes, correct? In that yes scene, we are given a prompt, let begin, which department information you need. So here we have to, again, we have to give a suggestion, get a input from the user. Suggestion is, first one is computer science engineering. Engineering. Second one is mechanical engineering. Okay. I'm clicking save. Clicking save. Okay. Once it is done, here one more thing going to come called slot filling. Once you click the slot filling plus, here you already heard about actual parameters, formal parameters, right? The slot type you have to select as departments. So here we have given as a formal parameter, department types. Okay. And we have to say this slot is required. Once the slot is saved, then only we can go ahead. If you've seen this, if you click the slot is required. Okay. And here you can see session.params.department types. Once this slot is get a value from the user, then only it will execute. I'm just clicking this condition, and very simple. What I need to do, I'm going to add one condition here. I'm going to give the and condition, and we seen session dot params dot, what is the name we given? Department types, right? Department types equal to, so CSE or computer science, anything, the slot, how it is filled, like that. Or okay, so I'm just giving that question. I have some issues here. I'll just click save, and we'll see, might be our variable name is incorrect. I'm clicking the department again. Okay, you can note here what is the thing. 1 minute. Okay, we are giving department types is equal to compression string. That is correct, right? Invalid conditions. We have to give double equal to, single equal to the assignment operator. Okay, now it's ready. So instead of giving the send prompt, I'm going to create one new scene called CSC. CSC or CSC. Okay, I'm clicking that CSC. Just giving the same enter send prompt. Welcome to here the variable going to work. Session dot params dot department types. I'm not going to tell which department, I'm telling the variable name. So this is the time for testing our application, how it goes. Till now, any doubts? Till now, the process, any doubts, any steps? Till now, any doubts in this? Okay. I will click the test. Okay. Hope now my actions on Google City will work correctly, I guess. Talk to my botex.
All right, let's get the test version of my botex.
Welcome to Arasu Engineering College. Are you ready for virtual tour?
Yes. Again, some glitch happened.
Okay, here's the test version of my bot X.
Welcome to Arasu Engineering College. Are you ready for virtual tour?
Yes.
Sorry, my bot X isn't responding right now.
So, try again soon. So the thing is, we have to debug here. What is the error happen? Before that, we are going to our application. Okay. We told when yes is matched, we are transit to yes. Here, while this parameters are matched, so department types, everything, the slot is required, we added department types equal to computer science engineering, and this is we added as a department, so here there is no issues. So title, send prompts, let begin which information you need. Okay, yes, this is also working fine. Okay, we have to check it here again, how we are added. So computer science engineering, okay, this is also we added correctly. So, okay. Give me a second. We'll debug where the error happened. It's interesting, right? Department types session dot params. We forgot about the dollar symbol here. Sorry. We'll check it now again, or else we'll give it in a directly. Okay, so slot filling have some glitches.
Okay, getting the test version of my bot X.
Welcome to
my bot X isn't responding right now. Please try again soon.
So you can use the standard Google Assistant feature in the simulator. I want to try them use. Okay, some glitches are. We have to check it again. Okay, now what I'm going to do, when S intent is matching, we are going for the S intent, right? So we are giving a suggestions here. I'll just remove this. Click save. Might be some of the thing is not saved. Let's check again. Okay, the thing was saved. Good. I'll delete this. I'll delete this and let's save. S intent I'm giving, let's begin. Which department information you need, like that, right? I am saved again. I will keep the test. As of now, any doubts, any constraint while I'm clicking the develop or test, you got any doubts in this? In this meantime, for updating, we can get along. Any doubts? Okay. Okay, this glitches will come obviously while we are developing the applications. Glitch has to become, then only we can learn. Because I'm given in our getting the test version of my bot X.
Welcome to Arasu Engineering College. Are you ready for virtual tour? Let's begin. Which department information you need?
Okay, so the thing is, it's happened in our parameters only. Okay. So our session span is too low. So I'm directly given this as a suggestions, and we'll match this intent directly. Okay. I'm given in a user intent handling. Instead of slot filling, I'm going for the user intent. It is already told you for we have to create a. We have to create a intent CSE. So previously I'm tried with the slot filling. It has some issues. So I'm go for the intent. Okay. I'm clicking the intent and instead of this, I'm directly add about the new scene called about. It will redirect to there. If this intent is matched, it will redirect to the about scene. Okay. In this intent, what are the things we need to add? We have to add the training phrase again, correct? So this training phrase should be additional parameter. Parameters is not needed here. So we can say CSE, CS, computer science, engineering. So we can add the phrase. This is enough, I guess. 1 minute. Okay, so if you click save, where we need to add this, once we click the yes, it should be mapped to our user intent, correct? We have to click here CSE transition to CSE. Okay. Now, how the flow will work? If it is yes, if the user intent is matched with CSE, then when that CSE is matched, so here it is not needed. We can directly say this prompt. So welcome to CSE. Okay. I'm just write a simple response here. Now again I test my application. I'm clicking that talk to my bot X.
Okay, here's the test version of my bot X.
Welcome to Arasu Engineering College. Are you ready for virtual tour? Let's begin. Which department information you need?
So I'm given CS.
Welcome to CFC.
See, we given the input and it asking welcome to CSE. So again, after it is telling welcome to CSE, we can give the intent. What is the intent we can add it? So now we already added the scene called about. Okay, about we not called it. We give the prompt here directly. In about, again in about, in on enter, we can give some prompt. It's like a flowchart kind of thing, correct? So I'm taking some sample from. Okay, and one more thing. Once it is done, I will show you Google NLP. NLP API, how it has worked. That is also. And we can show some content also here. So I'm already wrote the content. We have some toppers or faculty list in our table, right? So that if you open Arasu Engineering College website, you can go and click the about and tables. That table, how we can create, that is I'm going to show it now. So I have some faculty list I'm already taken for a sample. I'll just paste it here, paste it, and I will show you how that is work. Okay. Okay, let me format this. Give me a second. I have already some list of content. It's a issue of copy and paste. Okay, I'm just have some issues in table also, I guess. Okay. Okay, just wait, it will give this input only, table and subtitle. Columns. Columns. So we'll add one by one. Might be I'm just pasted directly. It happened, that issue happened. Incorrect prompt syntax once again. Okay. Some extra line issues in this. Okay, no issues. We'll remove this. I'll just add only one row for a quick, okay? Okay, I'm just added only one row here because some formatting issues there. We have to see it and develop this code. This 2-hour span is very less. We have to discuss in person. Okay, I'm going to click test.
Version of my bot X.
Welcome to Arasu Engineering College. Are you ready for virtual tour? Let's begin. Which department information you need?
I'm clicking CS.
Welcome to CSE.
Okay, I'm have to give about.
Sorry, I didn't catch that.
So we added the about and we are not added the matched intent, correct? So that is very important. Here I am just added the years and about. We are not matched our intent, so we have to write the intent called about, and we have to give a transition to the code. So intent about, again I'm giving about. Okay, so now we have a final test. Once this application was tested, we'll go to that Google NLP API, how it is working. Till now, are you clear? So I'm going to click the test button and we'll see the demo. Then again, I'm going to the Google NLU. Any doubts till now? Anyone? Yeah. Siva Surya, you can unmute and can speak. Siva Surya, staff or student? I don't know. Sorry. Siva Surya, are you able to hear? Okay, I'll just show the demo now.
Okay, let's get the test version of my bot X.
Welcome to Arasu. Let's begin. Which department information you need?
I'm telling CS.
Welcome to CSE.
So I'm giving about, clicking about.
The Department of Computer Science and Engineering strives to provide high-quality education in computer domains and follows outcome-based education. Oh.
So hope you are seeing that table what we developed here. It came some of the syntax issues, some spaces, and all YAML will not detect properly. That's why I given a one row. Okay, I finished my demo of Google Assistant actions on Google. Any doubts as of now? Any doubts? Anuradha ma'am, right? Anuradha Keshwar, student. Any doubts? Can I move to that Google NLP? I go to the Google NLP final demo section. Okay, give me a minute, I'll just share it. Okay, okay, I'm going to share that page. It is available in that Google API. Even you can use it. Okay. So here you can see it's a Google Cloud natural language. We have an insightful text analysis, AutoML natural language, everything. What I'm going to do here, once we click analyze, what will happen if you click, if you are trying to analyze this content, if you click analyze, have to click not robot. See, what are the things we have seen? Entities, sentiment, syntax, categories. Here entities, it clearly shows Google is the organization, location is Mountain View, and consumer good, what are the things they are doing, every information it will come. So it will separate it into the different entities. It will separate. See, you can see the syntax here. In the syntax, it will say how everything was separated. What is noun, which one is punctuation, everything. So for example, I'm going to open the Arasu Engineering College site.
Sir, your screen is not visible to us, sir.
Okay, one second. I will share it again. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I will show it again. So in Google Cloud, we have a natural language API. Okay, in this API demo, I'm going to show you this API. The content I'm going to take on Arasu Engineering College. We have a about section. Welcome to Arasu Engineering College. This section is there, right? I'm just copy the section and I'm put it here. Okay, so I'm going to click analyze. Okay. You can see it does separate. See, Arasu Engineering College is the organization. It will show the Wikipedia article also, and it will open. But this is some glitch. So his name is not organization one. It need to be improved. That Kumbakonam is the location. So other things. So person, the students mean here it is taking as a person. Engineering College means organization. Everything it is take it as a separate entities. Sentiment analysis, how the sentiment analysis, the entire document, how the score and magnitude is there for the sentiment analysis. Okay, you can see every entity level sentiment. This sentiment analysis, so how organization will speak here, organizational magnitude is 0.1. So everywhere, see how the location is a 0.9. So it is mentioning about the campus is 0.2, everything is showing like that. Then syntax. Syntax, what I told you already. It's loading once again. The content is huge, right? So we'll take the syntax. Okay, we'll move to the syntax. We'll wait for a few seconds. We'll load the syntax. Okay, but before moving into that, hope you understand about that natural language processing. If I missed any content and all, you can give it in a feedback section. So what I need to improve my site, and my final slide I have to show. Okay. Queries, I'm already asked. Any queries? Okay. So I like to dedicate this thing to God and my beloved staffs. My grandparents, mom, dad, especially my wife and daughter, my friends and well-wishers. Thank you, one and all. I finished my session. If you have any doubts, you can ask. By the meantime, it is loading. Might be have some network issue. It is not loaded. The syntax same like what I showed you, right? If I click retest, and I'll just retest again. I'll just show it to you. Okay. Syntax will work like that only. How the dependency and pass label, part of speech, lemma and morphology. So everything will come like that. I done my session. Any doubts as of now? Okay. I didn't get any...
Participants, if you have any queries, please put it in the chat box. Else, unmute yourself and ask.
I am just dedicated this 7 minutes for query section only. Don't worry, it's not reflect your internal marks, students. Any doubts?
So they are replying in chat box, sir.
Okay, ma'am. I'm just seeing that. Thank you, Pranesh. Manisha, thank you, Radhakrishnan. So, what are the things I need to improve my side? You can share your feedback as well as, and it's like, it is not like I know everything. It's like a learning process. Even I'm learning something, I'm shared with you peoples. Okay. Okay, before going to end the session, small video clip for artificial intelligence. We'll see that video. Okay, thank you, and I like to share. I like to thank to Parvati ma'am and Hachodi sir and college management. And sir, I like to share.